We're going to have a look at an example of a word problem that leads to an equation and discuss how we might go about solving things like this. Here's the scenario. I buy a shirt, trousers and some shoes. The shoes cost 3 times as much as the trousers. The shirt costs 30 Rand less than the trousers. I pay 970 Rand for the shirt, trousers and shoes altogether. How much did the trousers cost? Instead of jumping straight into trying to write an equation, it's actually often very useful to really just summarize this so we don't get lost in all the words and we're very clear of what's going on. So let's go through it step by step. It says, I buy a shirt, okay, trousers, and some shoes. They tell me then, the shoes cost 3 times as much as the trousers. So I'm just going to summarize that. And then the shirt costs 30 Rand less than the trousers. So I summarize that. Then it tells me I pay 970 Rand for all of those three things together. So the total cost is 970. And then the thing they're telling me to work out is how much did the trousers cost. So again, I summarize that. Now I look at this little picture and it's very clear to me what's going on. And now I'm going to work towards writing an equation to represent this scenario. And I'm going to choose to call the cost of the trousers X. And the reason I'm doing this is because that's what we're trying to find out. We're trying to find out what the cost of the trousers are. So that's the unknown, the X that we're trying to find out. It's also useful to start with the cost of the trousers because, of course, the cost of the shoes and the cost of the shirt are both related to the cost of the trousers. All right, so that's the kind of thinking I'm busy doing in my head. What do I write down? The very first thing I must write down is I must tell the person who's going to be looking at my solution what I've chosen to call X so they can understand it. So I say, let the cost of the trousers be X. All right, now once I have called the cost of the trousers X, it's easy for me to write an expression for the cost of the shirt because the shirt is just 30 Rand less than the trousers. So it means that if I take the cost of the trousers and I subtract 30, I'll get the cost of the shirt. So it's X minus 30 is the cost of the shirt. What about those shoes? They cost 3 times as much as the trousers. So they're going to be given by an expression of 3X. Now I know if I add all those costs together, I'll get 970. And so I can write the equation. The cost of the shirt, X minus 30, plus the cost of the trousers, X, plus the cost of the shoes, 3X, is equal to 970. Now I solve this equation. First, let's just combine the like terms. X plus X is 2X, plus 3X is 5X. So it's 5X minus 30 is 970. Right, I want to get rid of the numbers on the left, so I add 30 to both sides of this equation, and I get 5x is 1,000. I want to get my x on its own, so I divide both sides of the equation by 5, and I get x is 200. And now I need to write my answer really nicely, and I need to say, all right, I've worked out x is the cost of the trousers, that's what I was asked to work out, and so I write it. The trousers cost 200 Rand. Just a few points to notice here that will help you with your solving of word problems in general. Firstly, it is actually quite important to spend a little time making a quick summary or making very, very sure that you actually understand what the little scenario is all about. It's very easy to get lost in all those words. The second thing is, be very clear about what you are calling X and actually write it down. This makes it easier for the person to follow what you are doing when you solve, but it also makes it easier for you to be clear about what you're doing. And finally, don't forget, in a word problem, we really do want to, at the end, actually answer the word problem properly.